In today's video, I'm going to tell you about 23 different breathing techniques and breathwork modalities that are as powerful as Wim Hof Method. Enjoy! Hi there, it's Tomek with Breathwork Beats. Today I prepared for you 23 breathing techniques, breathing exercises, breathing modalities that you can use by yourself. You can explore other methods than Wim Hof Method. I'm creating this video because I feel that they are not as popular as Wim Hof Method. I don't have anything against Wim Hof breathing, but I feel there is much more in the breathwork field, and we can try so many different techniques that do different things than Wim Hof Method, or do very similar things to his method. I just feel that there is much more to explore, and these are the tools you can use to not to get bored by your daily practice. I like to shift in between the practices, in between the techniques, to keep my mind fresh, to not to get bored with one technique or the other. Experiment with different breathworks and see how much of an influence they have on my mood, on my physiology and my psyche. So if you can't stick to one specific practice, this video is for you. You are going to learn 23 different breathing techniques. Let's go. One more thing before we start. To every technique I'm going to present, there will be a video I'm going to upload here. And if you would like to explore more of this technique, I would highly recommend you to just jump into this video, which will be dedicated to a specific technique I'm talking about. Let's go with 23 techniques. First one, Pranayama breathing. Pranayama breathing comes from Hinduism. This is technique that is used in yoga tradition, that is used in yoga practice. These are very different postures and breathing techniques that they are using in yoga, and every one of them is serving a specific purpose. If you would like to dig deeper and if you would like to discover more of what pranayama is, I would highly recommend you to dive in, and you won't regret it. There's plenty of different techniques, alternate nostril breathing, using your diaphragm. This is an ancient technique developed by ancient traditions like Hinduism that were developed to grow yourself spiritually and personally. Number two, Buteyko breathing. Buteyko breathing technique is a wonderful technique for people struggling with asthma and allergies. It was invented by Konstantin Buteyko, a Russian researcher, in 1950s, and it was approved by Russian institutes and was practiced all around the Russia, then spread all around the world. Right now, this technique is popularized by Peter McKeon, who wrote a book which is called Oxygen Advantage. People also use this technique to regulate their nervous system and find the emotional and physical balance. Buteyko breathing is a very well-researched breathwork practice and breathing exercises that can help you to really improve your health and well-being. Number three, box breathing. Box breathing is a technique invented by Navy SEALs, Special Forces. They were using it to stay calm in a stressful situation. I've also created a separate video about box breathing. You can jump in here and check this video. It's a powerful technique for staying relaxed and staying calm in stressful situations. Technique number four, 49 breaths by Dr. Sid Williams. It was a technique invented by Dr. Sid Williams, a popular and successful chiropractor in the United States. He invented this method that we are mixing breathing exercises with affirmations and activations. And a while ago, I created a breathing meditation based on this technique performed by Dr. Brett Jones, also very successful chiropractor from United States, from California. He was performing this technique on his workshop in Germany, and I've made a music to his guidance, and this technique is on my YouTube channel. It will be popping right there, and you can check it out and see how 49 breaths works for you. Number five, holotropic breathwork. And holotropic breathwork technique invented by Stanislav Grof. It's a scientist, psychologist, founder of transpersonal psychology. He was was a pioneer in looking at human psyche in a totally different way. He developed a practice which is called holotropic breathwork. I've also made a video about my experience with holotropic breathwork. It's a very powerful technique for healing trauma, for reprogramming your subconscious mind, and for spiritual and personal growth. I would highly recommend everybody to check out holotropic breathwork. Technique number six, rebirthing breathwork. Rebirthing breathwork is a little bit similar to holotropic breathwork, I would say, but there are small differences in between. Founder of rebirthing breathwork, Leonard Orr, structured this practice in a little bit different way than holotropic breathwork. In holotropic breathwork, there is a group of people breathing at the same time. At rebirthing breathwork workshops, it's more an individual approach, and there are plenty of small differences in between. Again, it's also a very intense advanced breathing practice that is recommended to do with a skilled facilitator, which is going to help you to go through a deeper healing and more intense experience. Rebirthing breathwork also is a perfect tool for healing trauma and reprogramming your subconscious mind, also spiritual growth, the same benefits that we have in holotropic breathwork. Technique number seven, coherent breathing. I've also made a separate video about coherent breathing. It's a beautiful, very simple technique invented by Dr. Stephen Elliott and popularized by Dr. Patricia Gerbark and Dr. Richard Brown. This technique is very simple. You can use it daily. It's recommended to use this technique for 20 minutes a day. And if you do this technique regularly, the benefits are endless, actually. If you would like to learn more about this technique, check out my video. Check out the work of these people. I'm going to put the links into a description of this video. Coherent breathing, very simple technique, but very powerful. Don't underestimate it. Number eight, Sufi breathing. Sufi breathing has a long tradition, and in Sufism, they were using breathwork for many different purposes, to connect to God, to connect to spirit, for spiritual growth. They were using very rapid breathing techniques by changing tempo and changing the rhythm of the breath, to evoke a specific changes in their spirit and in their bodies. So you can check this video to check out how the Sufi breathing works. It's very interesting practice. You can try for yourself. I really enjoy this kind of breathing. I really enjoy improvising with breathing and trying different methods, especially if I see this kind of video that I can follow the different breathing practice. It's very useful, it's very playful, and you can be amazed about the results. It's a powerful breathing technique invented by these traditions, specifically here by Sufism, which is powerful, and it helps you with your personal and spiritual growth like nothing else. Technique number nine, Joe Dispenza breathing meditation. And I've talked about Dr. Joe Dispenza and his work in my previous videos. I'm a huge fan of his work, of his book, Becoming Supernatural, and his previous book, which is called You Are the Placebo. He's using this technique to activate a specific energy centers in our body. And you can call it chakras, you can call it energy centers. It's all there, it's not even questionable anymore. I think the science is going to catch up with all of this pretty soon. Right now, we have only experiential proofs about that. His work is a specific bridge between actually spirituality and modern science. So if you would like to enhance your meditation, Joe Dispenza breathing techniques is for you. It's going to help you stay grounded, to wake up all of the energy centers in your body and get the full benefits of the meditation. Breathwork number 10. It's more of a breathwork modality. It's a set of exercises and set of practices, which is called Breatheology. Breatheology was invented by Stig Severinsen, a Swedish guy who is a world record holder in breath hold, actually. And he holded his breath for 22 minutes. And this is just mind-blowing what this guy is doing. And he also has his program, which is called Breatheology, where he explore a variety of different topics. He is using breath holds. He is using a lot of exercises based on breath holds, but also his offers is very wide, and he is using nasal breathing, breath packing, and using different breathing techniques for different purposes. Fascinating guy, a lot of things to learn from him. Check out Breatheology. Breathing exercise number 11, 20 connected breaths. 20 connected breaths is a simple version of Rebirthing Breathwork. It was an exercise invented by a founder of Rebirthing Breathwork, Leonard Orr. I've recently made a breathing meditation based on this technique. It's a very powerful technique for calming down, for staying grounded, for repatterning your mind and get rid of negative thinking and just rebooting, resetting your nervous system and your mind to stay more present. Check out 20 connected breaths. I use this technique very often. It's beyond powerful. The technique number 12, Tummo Breathing. And Tummo Breathing is a practice which is coming from Tibetan Buddhism. It's all about waking up your inner fire. And it's a combination of breathing technique with visualizations that is going to help you to wake up your inner fire. Tummo Breathing is a little bit more advanced practice. If you would like to check how Tummo Breathing is, I'm also uploading video here. Different techniques for different purposes, very interesting practice. You need to be a little bit open-minded here to really understand it or try to grasp it. Wim Hof method is pretty similar to Tummo Breathing. There are also small differences here and there, but you can see a huge inspiration. So Tummo Breathing, if you are open-minded, check the practice out. Fantastic practice. The technique number 13, anti-depression breath. I've also made a separate video about anti-depression breath. It's a technique popularized in Russia. It was approved by Russian Academy of Sciences, and it's a perfect practice to pick up your mood, to get you out of depression, of a state of low energy zone, and uplift your mood, uplift your spirit. Beautiful technique. You can use it everywhere you go. If you'd like to learn more about it, check out the video I've made specifically about anti-depression breath. Powerful technique. Use it in a situation when you feel really down or depressed. Technique number 14, heart coherence breathing. Heart coherence is a wonderful technique for harmonizing your heart and your brain and restoring the connection in between those two. It's a technique invented by HeartMath Institute, well researched by HeartMath Institute. I've also made a separate video about heart coherence breathing and heart coherence technique. You can check this video here if you'd like to learn more and learn how to practice it. If you'd like to learn more about this technique, I also recommend you to check the TED talk of one of the founders of HeartMath Institute, Dr. Howard Martin. It's a very well researched method. Check it out. Very simple technique also, but has a lot of benefits. Breathing technique number 15, SOMA Breathwork. SOMA Breathwork is a modality invented by Niraj Naik. I think I'm pronouncing well the name of the guy, and I'm not sure, sorry for that if I'm pronouncing wrong, but he developed a breathwork modality, breathwork practice, which is called SOMA Breathwork. It's a combination a little bit in my mind of Wim Hof style breathing with Pranayama breathing. They are using different techniques for different purposes, but their main technique is excessive, aggressive breathing that is going to help you to grow spiritually, get rid of trauma. Wonderful breathing technique. There is plenty of breathing meditations and free breathing exercises on YouTube that you can try for yourself. I'm going to upload a demo video here. Check it out, powerful breathing technique for spiritual growth. Technique number 16, activation breathing. And activation breathing comes from the work of Dr. Brett Jones. And Dr. Brett Jones is a successful chiropractor in the United States, in California. He made an online program, an online course, which is called Move, Breathe, Meditate. I followed this course and I've learned a ton of breathing exercises from there. One of the advanced techniques there is activation breathing. It's a set of movements with different breath and breath holds that activates all of the different energy centers in your body. Powerful breathing technique for spiritual growth. Highly recommend the program Move, Breathe, Meditate. Fantastic work. Technique number 17, Vivation Breathing. Vivation Breathing is a technique invented by Jim Leonard. Jim Leonard is a founder of Vivation Breathing, of Vivation Breathwork. It's a technique, it's a style of breathing that you breathe aggressively, that you breathe more intense, but at the same time you are trying to stay calm and present with every feeling that is coming from inside of you. And if there is some unpleasant feeling, there is a guidance during this breath work to enjoy this feeling as much as possible. And it's a powerful technique combining aggressive, more advanced breathing with a positive approach to every emotion that is coming up. Very powerful transformational breathwork. Technique number 18, vagus nerve activation breathing technique. So the vagus nerve is activating a lot of our processes in our body. It's regulating our sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous system balance. If you would like to research more about it, I highly recommend checking out the book, checking out the YouTube videos about the polyvagal theory. This theory was initiated by Dr. Stephen Porges, a scientist, a researcher with huge experience. And to stimulate this vagus nerve, we are using very gentle breathing exercises through the nose. We are adding a little bit extra to these breathing exercises through humming and through making sounds. This perfectly harmonizes our body and harmonizes nervous system. A lot of science behind that. Check out polyvagal theory and the breathing exercises around it. Technique number 19, Andrew Weil 478 breathing. I've also made a separate video about this technique. It's a very powerful technique invented by holistic health practitioner Dr. Andrew Weil, with a lot of experience. Very useful technique for the people who have problems with falling asleep, down-regulating your nervous system. It's helping you to calm down before going to sleep, and it also improves the quality of your sleep. Technique number 20, Kumnai breathing meditation. Kumnai is a Tibetan yoga practice that is rich in plenty of breathing exercises, in meditation exercises. It's a perfect tool for managing your energy for all of the different purposes. Here is a material about Kumnai. If you would like to research more about this powerful practice, check the video. Technique number 21, Qigong and Tai Chi exercises, practices. These are practices that has a long tradition. And it's a combination of movement and breathing, gentle rhythmic breathing, and synchronizing the breathing with the movement. This way, according to the tradition of Qigong and Tai Chi, in this way you are harmonizing your energy in your body and you are cultivating life force energy in your body, mind and spirit. Technique number 22, it's a modality, it's biodynamic breathwork. Biodynamic breathwork was invented by Girten Tonkov. It's a set of body work and movement combined with breathwork for trauma release and reprogramming your subconscious mind. Very powerful technique. I would compare it to holotropic breathwork a little bit, maybe to rebirthing breathwork a little bit also, but it's a separate modality. It's more complicated than that. They are using also a lot of body work there and biodynamics there. And also powerful method for trauma release. Breathing exercise number 23. We are almost there. It's getting darker and darker. I'm finishing this video number 23. It's a package of exercises and breathing techniques and it's called Breathwork Fundamentals by Dan Brule. It's an online course which is one of the most powerful courses I've saw, and Dan Brule is a master of breathwork, a guru in breathwork field with a great reputation throughout the breathwork practitioners. And he is getting rid out of every dogma about all of the different practices, and he is going into the essence of breathing techniques and breathwork practice. It's a 9-hour online course you can buy and go through. It's a wonderful, wonderful work explaining the basics of breathing exercises and breathwork and how we should use breathwork for personal growth, spiritual development, for healing, and for well-being. And I would highly recommend everybody who is interested in the field of breathwork and different breathing techniques to check out this course. Also, I benefited from it like from nothing else I can say. If it goes about online courses. So that's it. Thank you very much for staying with me. 23 breathing techniques. If you are interested in one of the breathing techniques I mentioned, check them out, practice by yourself. It's a very experiential thing. We need to practice daily to really benefit from these exercises. And I will be repeating this over and over again, but this is the crucial part of it. Do these exercises daily, stick to one practice. If you are bored with one practice, change it to another one. It's very simple. It's simple as that. You don't need to be dogmatic about it. You don't need to be rigid. Freestyle with the breathwork. Use different techniques and see how they work for you. If they are helping you or maybe not, try a different one. Try aggressive breathing, try simple calming breathing techniques, combined breathing with meditation. Thanks one more time for your attention here, and if you would like to see more of this kind of videos, subscribe to my channel, and I will highly appreciate any comments, likes, even sharing this video with your friend, with close one. Thanks one more time for your time and attention here. It's super dark right now. I hope this video will be useful. Thanks one more time. See you around.